Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Anatoma. We are in the part 6 of the series on segmental anatomy of the liver. In this video, we will be covering the four segments of the left physiological lobe of the liver. Just to recap, in the previous videos, we have classified the liver from anatomical lobe to a new definition of a physiological lobe, then sectors, finally segments. We have proceeded to identify the various segments, four in the right lobe and four in the left lobe. By the word lobe, I mean physiological lobes. So we know the location of these lobes. Only thing is, we need to do some dissections inside the segments and try to identify the portal vein and its branches, or the hepatic vein and its tributaries. Therefore, the focus is now on these two segments of the left lobe. This is as seen from the superior view. Likewise, from the front view, you will notice the yellow arrows are the segments in focus for today's discussion. Segment 4, segment 3, segment 2. You must be wondering, where is the segment 1? We'll come to that. Now you see, in the inferior surface, once again, drawing your attention to segment 3 and segment 2. Now you see, let's start with segment 1. The caudate lobe itself is considered segment 1, and there is a flashing yellow color arrow as the left branch proceeds into the physiological left lobe. You can see a branch given off to the caudate lobe. That's the branch from the portal vein given off to the caudate lobe. Not labeled in this dissection, but very much present are the branches of the hepatic artery and the bile duct. I mean, we have kept it aside from the discussion, but please remember they are also very much present. Next, the frontal view, the focus is on segment number 4 to the left of the primary fissure, or primary, or the major portal fissure, the main portal fissure. Now, that on the other side, limiting it on the left, is the umbilical fissure, and we have made a triangular wedge-shaped area we have removed of the parenchyma. It's a lid, actually. I have removed it like a lid so that I can fit it back as and when required. Now, notice very carefully, I have mentioned about the difficulty in dissection and demonstration, namely, these branches of the portal vein are semi-transparent. So unless you actually see in the dissection, it's difficult to appreciate, but I have done my best to show it. Here is the branch from the left portal vein, specifically going into the segment number 4. To supplement this information, I have made a semi-diagrammatic version. I have painted the thing to show the same branches of the portal vein. That is, from the left portal, here is a segmental branch. I repeat, left sectorial branch gives the segmental branch to the segment 4. Next, inferior view of the liver. Once again, the focus is on the left lobe. The reason why I have done this particular dissection on the inferior surface only is, I notice that as the portal vein left branch is traced, it is easy to dissect from the inferior surface. That's all, no other reason. Because of that easy of continuity of the dissection, I have made a triangular wedge-shaped area, removed the parenchyma, and I'm done. You can actually already see the yellow arrow pointing to the branches to the segment number 2. Segment number 3 also dissected, but the view or the angle of the photograph is not appropriate, so I am not able to show you, but in the immediate slide that follows you will see that also. You see, now here is the semi-diagrammatic conversion where I have painted the portal veins for easier identification. You can see the corresponding segmental branches of the left portal vein to these two segments, namely segment 2 and segment 3. Next, these are all supplementary labels to help you with the orientation in case you find it difficult. The quadrate lobe and the caudate lobe and the gallbladder are important landmarks by which you can remember the segmental association. You see, that's the caudate lobe. IVC impression, all these help you locate the lobe or the segment better. Now, that was an overview of the segmental anatomy of the left physiological lobe of the liver. Now, although we have almost completed the series on the segmental anatomy of the liver, there is one more video that follows this. I am currently working on it. Now, that video will be a summary video. In that video, we will try to identify the lobes of the segments of the liver in all possible views: superior, inferior, posterior, anterior, and try to summarize all the other details that we have understood in terms of the branching of the portal vein, the tributaries of the hepatic vein, etc. Try to bring in a summary video. Thank you for your patient listening, my dear friends.